أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد. We shall now continue with ayah number 47 of Surah Al-Mumin. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وإذ يتحاجون في النار. And just imagine when the people in the hell, in the fire, will be quarreling with each other. فيقول الضعفاء للذين استكبروا. Those people who were oppressed in this world, they will say to their leaders who were arrogant, إِنَّا كُنَّا لَكُمْ تَبَعًا. We were your followers in that world. فَهَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُغْنُونَ عَنَّا نَصِيبًا مِنَ النَّارِ. So now, can you avert from us at least some portion of this fire? Can you get the intensity of the fire reduced for us? قَالَ الَّذِينَ اسْتَكْبَرُوا. Then those who were arrogant in the world, they would say, إِنَّا كُلٌّ فِيهَا. We are all in this fire. إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ حَكَمَ بَيْنَ الْعِبَادِ. Verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has judged between His servants. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ فِي النَّارِ لِخَزَنَةِ جَهَنَّمِ. And now these people who will be in the fire, they will say to the keepers of the hell, اُدْعُوا رَبَّكُمْ يُخَفِّفْ عَنَّا يَوْمًا مِنَ الْعَذَابِ. Please pray to your Lord so that He may lighten for us a day of chastisement. قَالُوا أَوَلَمْ تَكُ تَعْتِيكُمْ رُسُلُكُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ. They will say, did not your messengers come to you with clear proofs? قَالُوا بَلَى. They will say, yes, they did come. قَالُوا فَدْعُوا. Then they will say, now you pray yourself. We are not going to ask the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for you. وَمَا دُعَاءُ الْكَافِرِينَ إِلَّا فِي ضَلَالٍ. And the praying of the disbelievers is but in vain. No use. The disbelievers, when they are praying to Allah, in the same way, those who say we believe, but don't act accordingly, their prayers also not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't listen. Unless they repent, decide, make a covenant, now I will not do anything wrong, then Allah will listen to his prayers and grant his prayers. إِنَّا لَنَنْصُرُ رُسُلَنَا وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Surely we shall help our messengers and those who believed in us in the life of this world. وَيَوْمَ يَقُومُ الْأَشْهَادُ. And also on the day when the witnesses will stand. يَوْمَ يَنْفَعُ الظَّالِمِينَ مَعْذِرَتُهُمْ. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ الظَّالِمِينَ مَعْذِرَتُهُمْ. The day when these evil doers will not be able to avail of any excuses. وَلَهُمُ اللَّعْنَةُ. And there will be for them the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَهُمْ سُوُدَّارُ. And theirs will be the evil abode. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْهُدَىٰ وَأَوْرَثْنَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ الْكِتَابِ. And we gave Musa alayhi salatu wasalam guidance. And we made the children of Israel inheritors of that book. هُدًى وَذِكْرَى لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. That book, Torah, was a guidance and an admonition for men of understanding. فَصْبِرْ. So, O you Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, have patience, persevere. إِنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ. The promise of Allah is going to be true. وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكَ. And you apologize to Allah and ask His forgiveness for any shortcomings that might have come from you. وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ and glorify Allah, your Lord, with His praise, بِالْعَشِيَّ وَالْإِبْكَارِ during the evenings and during the mornings. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُجَادِلُونَ فِي آيَاتِ اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ سُلْطَانٍ أَتَاهُمْ. Verily those who dispute concerning the revelations of Allah without any authority that might have come to them. إِنْ فِي صُدُورِهِمْ إِلَّا كِبْرٌ. Actually in their chest there is pride and arrogance. مَا هُمْ بِبَالِغِي which they can never attain. فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ. So O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you seek the refuge of Allah. إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. Verily He is all listening and all seeing. لَخَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ أَكْبَرُ مِنْ خَلْقِ النَّاسِ. The creation of heaven and earth was definitely greater and more difficult than the creation of the people. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. But most of the people don't have the knowledge. وَمَا يَسْتَوِي الْأَعْمَى وَالْبَصِيرُ. And a person who sees and a person who is blind, they are not equal. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَلَا الْمُسِيءِ. In the same way, those who believe and do good deeds are not equal to those who are committing errors and evils. قَلِيلًا مَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. But little is the admonition that you get. إِنَّ السَّاعَةَ لَآتِيَةٌ. Surely, definitely, that hour is to come. It will come. لَا رَيْبَ فِيهَا. There is no doubt in it. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. But most of the people are not going to believe. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ ادْعُونِي يَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Now this ayah is also very important regarding the main theme of this surah. Dua. Dua to Allah. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ ادْعُونِي يَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. And your Lord says, call upon me, I will listen to your prayers, I will grant your prayers. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنِ عِبَادَتِي. Verily those who don't pray to me, who don't worship me out of arrogance, سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِرِينَ. They will enter the hell disgraced. So dua and ibadah are synonymous. قَالَ رَبُّكُمُ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِرِينَ. So first the word dua has come and then ibadah, because they are synonymous. I gave you the ahadith, الدُعَاء مُخُّ الْعِبَادَةِ. Dua, prayer is the essence of worship. الدُعَاء هُوَ الْعِبَادَةِ. Dua actually, prayer is actually the worship. اللَّهُ الَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمُ اللَّيْلَ لِتَسْكُنُوا فِيهِ وَالنَّهَارَ مُبْصِرًا. It is Allah who made for you the night so that you can have respite in it, repose in it. And He made day where you can see. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَذُو فَضْلٍ عَلَى النَّاسِ. And verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is full of bounty for the people. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَشْكُرُونَ. But most of the people, they don't give thanks. ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبُّكُمْ خَالِقُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. He is Allah, your Lord, creator of everything. لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُ. There is no God except Him. فَأَنَّا تُفَكُونَ. So where from are you being diverted or deviated? كَذَلِكَ يُوفَقُ الَّذِينَ كَانُوا بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ يَجْحَدُونَ. In the same way, those were also in the past diverted or perverted who belied the revelation of their Lord. اللَّهُ الَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمُ الْأَرْضَ قَرَارًا. It is Allah who has made for you this earth as a resting place. وَالسَّمَاءَ بِنَاءً. And He has made this heaven a roof. وَصَوَّرَكُمْ فَأَحْسَنَ صُوَرَكُمْ. And He has fashioned you and fashioned your form so well. وَرَزَقَكُمُ الطَّيِّبَاتِ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ. And He has provided you with the best foods, with very pure foods. Lord of the... ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبُّكُمْ. He is Allah, your Lord. فَتَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. So blessed is Allah who is the Lord of all the worlds. هُوَ الْحَيِّ. He is ever living. لَا إِلَىٰ إِلَّهُ. There is no God except Him. فَدْعُوهُ مُخْلِسِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. So call upon Him, but keeping your obedience exclusive for Him. Again this word has come. مُخْلِسِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. فَدْعُوهُ. Do call upon Him. Do pray Him. But you know, the prerequisite is that you have your obedience, to absolute obedience, totally reserved for him, for nobody else. Anybody else can be obeyed where there is no disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if it entails the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is not to be obeyed. Whether he is your father or mother or husband or ruler or whosoever he is, who commands something contrary to the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is not to be obeyed. This is tawheed. Tawheed fil ita'ah. This is the tawheed in obedience. And that, in the same way, tawheed fil mahabbah. Tawheed in love. You can love your children, you can love your spouses, you can love your parents, you can love your country. But Allah's love must be above all these. If the love of any one of these things becomes equal to the love of Allah, it is shirk. Now he is sitting by the side of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the throne of your heart. You are loving that thing also, just equal to your love with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what to say when the love of something exceeds the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Ta'is Abduddin, Arif Abduddin, I have already quoted this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The worshippers of dinar and dirham, nobody has bowed before dinar and dirham. Nobody has prostrated before dinar and dirham. You know the Hindus, they worship Lakshmi Bai. Why? Because if Lakshmi Devi is happy, then she would grant us wealth. And what do we say? Remove this Lakshmi Bai from between. We will worship the wealth itself directly. That's all. Why to have this Lakshmi Devi in between? We can worship the wealth directly. And this is what we are doing, if you don't mind it. He is ever living. There is no God except him. فَدْعُوهُ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ So call upon him. But keeping your absolute obedience reserved for Allah. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. All praise is for Allah, who is the Lord of all the worlds. قُلْ إِنِّي نُهِيتُ أَنْ أَعْبُدَ الَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ لَمَّا جَانِيَ الْبَرِيَّنَاتُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I have been forbidden. I can't worship those whom you are calling upon besides Allah. When clear signs and ayat have come to me from my Lord, وَأُمِرْتُ أَنْ أُسْلِمَ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ And I have been commanded to surrender myself to the Lord of all the worlds. هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ تُرَابٍ It is He who created you out of clay, mud, ثُمَّ مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ Then from the sperm drop, ثُمَّ مِنْ عَلَقَةٍ Then from a clot of blood, as it used to be translated formerly, but a hanging piece, you know, just like the leech which hangs from the wall of the womb of the mother. ثُمَّ يُخْرِجُكُمْ تِفْلًا Then he brings you forth as a child, as an infant. ثُمَّ لِتَبْلُغُوا أَشُدَّكُمْ Then so that you reach your maturity. ثُمَّ لِتَكُونُوا شُيُوخًا And then so that you become old. وَمِنْكُمْ مَنْ يُتَوَفَّى مِنْ قَبْلِ Some of you, they are put to death before that time. وَلِتَبْلُغُوا أَجَلًا مُسَمَّى And that a time which is fixed for you, you have to attain it. وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ And so that you ponder over these things. Allah who has done all this, He can create you again also. هُوَ الَّذِي يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتُ It is He who gives life and He puts to death. فَإِذَا قَضَى أَمْرًا And when He has made its decision, فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ So only He has to say for it, be, and it becomes. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ يُجَادِلُونَ فِي آيَاتِ اللَّهِ Don't you see to those who dispute the revelations of Allah, anna yusrafun, from where are they being diverted away and turned away? Allazina kazzabu bil kitab, wa bima arsalna bihi rusuluna, those people who belied our book, and those whom we sent with the book, that is our messengers, fasawfa ya'lamun, very soon they will come to know, they will come to their senses. Izil aghlalu fi anaqihim, when there will be fetters on their necks, وَالسَّلَاسِلَ There will be chains, يُسْحَبُونَ They will be dragged, فِي الْحَمِيمِ In boiling water, ثُمَّ فِي النَّارِ يُسْجَرُونَ And then they will be thrown into the fire. ثُمَّ قِيلَ لَهُمْ أَيْنَ مَا كُنْتُمْ تُشْرِكُونَ Then it will be said to them, where are those whom you associated with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they can save you from the punishment. They can intercede on your behalf and save you from the accountability of the Day of Judgment. مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ besides Allah, قَالُوا ضَلُّوا عَنَّا They will say, they all have vanished. They all have been lost. بَلْ لَمْ نَكُنْ نَدُوا مِنْ قَبْلْ شَيَا But now we have come to understand that we were not calling upon anything. These were whims only. We thought that they have something. This was no reality. كَذَلِكَ يُضُلُّ اللَّهُ الْكَافِرِينَ In this way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends astray the disbelievers. ذَلِكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَفْرَحُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ This is because of which you were rejoicing in the world in the earth, بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ without any right. وَبِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَمْرَحُونَ And because you were exalting yourself. اُدْخُلُوا أَبْوَابَ جَهَنَّمَ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا Now enter the doors of the hell to abide by there forever. فَبِئْسَ مَثْوَى الْمُتَكَبِّرِينَ So very bad will be the abode of the arrogant. فَاصْبِرْ As to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, have patience. Be patient. إِنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ Verily Allah's promise is going to come true. Allah's help will come. He will destroy your enemies. But so it's only a question of time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to give them some respite. There is a fixed term for them. When that term comes to end, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send the chastisement for them. إِنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ فَإِمَّا نُرِيَنَّكَ بَعْضَ الَّذِينَ عَيْدُهُمْ أَوْ نَتَوَفَّيَنَّكَ فَإِلَيْنَا يُرْجَعُونَ Now this is also possible that we show you in your own lifetime some of that which we are promising them, that the chastisement might come to them in your lifetime. أَوْ نَتَوَفَّيَنَّكَ And this is also possible that we call you unto us back, فَإِلَيْنَا يُرْجَعُونَ And then they also will be returned to us. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلًا مِّن قَبْلِكَ And we sent many messengers before you. مِنْهُمْ مَنْ قَصَصْنَا عَلَيْكَ Some of them we have narrated to you, their conditions, their histories, their stories. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ لَمْ نَقْصُصْ عَلَيْكَ And there are so many among them whom we have not mentioned to you. وَمَا كَانَ لِرَسُولٍ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ بِآيَةٍ And there was not possible for any messenger that he could bring any sign إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ except with the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِذَا جَاءَ أَمْرُ اللَّهِ قُضِيَ بِالْحَقِّ And when the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came, then everything was decided with justice and truth. وَخَسِرَ هُنَالِكَ الْمُبْتَلُونَ And then those who were having falsehood, they were in the loss. اللَّهُ الَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمْ الْأَنْعَامَ لِتَرْكَبُوا مِنْهَا وَمِنْهَا تَعْكُلُونَ It is Allah who has made for you this cattle so that you ride them and also from them you eat. Their meat you eat. وَلَكُمْ فِيَا مَنَافِعُ There are others uses for them, for you in them. وَلِتَبْلُغُوا عَلَيْهَا حَاجَةً فِي صُدُورِكُمْ And so that you can reach to fulfill the need that you have in your minds. وَعَلَيْهَا وَعَلَى الْفُلْكِ تُحْبَلُونَ And on them And on the ships and boats, you are carried. وَيُرِيكُمْ آيَاتِهِ And he shows you his signs. فَأَيَّ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ تُنْكِرُونَ So which signs of Allah will you deny? أَفَلَمْ يَسِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ Have they not traveled in the land? فَيَنْظُرُوا So that they should see كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ What was the end of those who were before them? كانوا أكثر منهم وأشد قوة وأثارا في الأرض. They were more than them in numbers and mightier in power than them. And they left signs and monuments in the land. فما أغنى عنهم ما كانوا يكسبون. But when the chastisement of Allah came, nothing could avail them. Nothing could save them. فلما جاءتهم رسلهم بالبينات. But when our messengers came to them with clear signs, فرحوا بما عندهم. They kept rejoicing at what they had already. Their creeds, their culture, their customs, their false gods. They were happy with them. فَرَيْهُ بِمَا عِنْدَهُ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ وَحَاقَ بِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا بِهِ يَسْتَهْزِئُونَ. But in the long run, those things about which they were mocking and laughing, they came and they encompassed them. فَلَمَّا رَأَوْا بَأْسَنَا, when they saw our might, قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ, then they said, we believe in Allah وَحْدَهُ, the alone. وَكَفَرْنَا بِمَا كُنَّا بِهِ مُشْرِكِينَ, and now we deny and reject those whom we had been associating with Allah. فَلَمْ يَكُوْ يَنْفَعُهُمْ إِمَانُهُمْ, but now their iman, their believing was of no avail to them, of no use to them. لَمَّا رَأَوْا بَأْسَنَا, when they had seen our chastisement and our might. سُنَّةَ اللَّهِ الَّتِي قَدْ خَلَتْ فِي عِبَادِهِ, this has been the disposition or rule or law or practice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all his servants whom he had sent before. وَخَسِرَ هُنَالِكَ الْكَافِرُونَ, and at that time the disbelievers are in loss. Now, Surah Hamim As-Sajda. This surah also has two names. Surah Fussilat. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Hamim. Tanzeelu min ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Sending down of this book, revealing down of this book, is from the one who is all compassionate and all merciful. Kitabun Fussilat Ayatum. From this is the second name, Fussilat. This is a book whose ayat are explained fully. Quran and Arabiyan liqawmi ya'lamun, in the form of an Arabic Quran for those people who have knowledge. Bashiram wa Nazira. And this has come as a Bashir, as a bearer of the glad tidings, wa Nazir, and a warner. فَعَرَضَ أَكْسَرُهُمْ فَهُمْ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ, but most of them are turning their faces away and they are not listening. وَقَالُوا قُلُوبُنَا فِي أَكِنَّةٍ مِمَّا تَدْعُونَا إِلَيْهِ, and they say arrogantly, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our hearts are under a veil from that which you are calling us. Your call is not reaching our hearts. There is a barrier. أَكِنَّةً مِمَّا تَدْعُونَا إِلَيْهِ وَفِي أَذَانِنَا وَقْرٌ, and you think that we are listening. No. In our ears there is some heaviness. We are not listening what you are saying. وَمِن بَيْنِنَا وَبَيْنِكَ حِجَابٌ, and between you and us there is a curtain. فَعْمَلْ إِنَّنَا عَامِلُونَ, so you go on doing what you are doing, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are also doing whatever we can do. قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, verily I am only a mortal human being like you. يُوحَى إِلَيَّ, but the revelation has come to me. أَنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهُ وَاحِدٌ, that your ilah, your Lord, is the only one ilah. فَاسْتَقِيمُوا إِلَيْهِ, so keep your faces fixed towards Him. وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا, and ask His forgiveness. وَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُشْرِكِينَ, and woe is, and disaster is for those who associate someone or something with Him. أَلَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ, those who don't give zakah, وَهُمْ بِالْآخِرَةِهُمْ كَافِرُونَ, and as for the hereafter, they absolutely reject it. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, on the contrary, those who come to believe and do good deeds, لَهُمْ أَجْرٌ غَيْرَ مَمْنُونَ, for them there is going to be a reward which will never come to an end, unending. قُلْ أَيْنَّكُمْ لَتَكْفُرُونَ بِالَّذِي خَلَقَ الْأَرْضَ فِي يَوْمَيْنِ, say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do you reject and disbelieve the Lord who created this earth in 2 days? وَتَجْعَلُونَ لَهُ أَنْدَادًا, and you are setting up rivals to Him, equals to Him. ذَلِكَ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ, He is the Lord of all the worlds. Now these ayat are again from mutashabihat. As I said so many times, that Allah created the heavens and the earth and whatever is in between them in 6 days. We can't know the reality of 6 days. Up till now, our science maybe, this theories of creation, etc., etc., we are probing and probing and probing. Maybe someday it is revealed to us, oh, this was the thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referred to as 6 days. Up till now, up till this day, it's not possible. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is splitting the creation of 6 days into 3 stages. Fi yawmain, first 2 days, he says, created the earth. Waja'ala fiha rawasiya. And then he fixed the mountains on the earth. Min fawqiha, from above. Wabaraka fiha. And then he blessed it. Waqaddara fiha aqwataha. And he ordained in it its sustenance. This earth has all the material that can sustain the life, all the food that we living beings need, all the requirements that are there. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set all these things from the very beginning in the earth. Fi arba'ati ayyam. This was completed in 4 days. 2 plus 2. 2 for the creation and 2 for making it inhabitable so that people can live here, animals can live here, and all this vegetation and all these requirements they can get. Sama'an lis-sa'ilin. And this is alike for all the seekers. Summa stava ila sama. Then he turned to the heaven. Wahiya dukhanun. And it was like a smoke. Now this word has come very near to the modern theories, you know. It was all like smoke. So it's one mass and just like smoke. But then they differentiated into different galaxies. ثُمَّ اسْتَوَىٰ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ وَهِيَ دُخَانٌ. It was like smoke. فَقَالَ لَا وَلِلْأَرْضِ اِقِيَا طَعُونَ وَكَرْحَىٰ. And then he said to the earth and to this mass, اِتِيَا, come to me, both of you, the sama, the heaven, as well as the earth, طَعُونَ وَكَرْحَىٰ, willingly or unwillingly. قَالَتَا أَتَيْنَا طَعِينَ. Both of them said, we are present, we come willingly. فَقَضَاهُنَّ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ فِي يَوْمَيْنِ. And now Allah differentiated that mass, Dukhan, into 7 heavens in 2 days. وَأَوْحَى فِي كُلِّ سَمَاءٍ أَمْرَهَا. And He revealed to all the heavens its matters, its command. وَزَيَّنَّ السَّمَاءَ الدُّنْيَا بِمَصَابِيحَ. And we adorned the lower heaven with lamps. وَحِفْظَ, and also guarding places. ذَلِكَ تَقْدِيرُ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَلِيمِ. This is the decree of the mighty and the knower. فَإِنْ أَرَضُوا. Now if they turn their faces away, قُلْ أَنْزَرْتُكُمْ صَائِقَةً مِثْلَ صَائِقَةِ آدٍ وَثَمُودَ. Say them, I have warned you of the thunderbolt, like the thunderbolt which came to Aad and Samud. Aad, to whom Hazrat Hud was sent, and Samud, to whom Hazrat Saleh was sent. Is jaatuhum rusulun min bayni aydihim wa min khalfihim. When to these people, Aad and Samud, their messengers came from front of them, also behind them. You know, the messengers took all the pains to convey the message. رَبَّ إِنِّي دَعَوْتُ قَوْمِ لَيْلًا وَنَهَارًا. We shall read it in Surah An-Nuh. Hazrat Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, Parvardigar, my Lord, I have been calling them during the day, during the night, calling upon each one of them individually, calling them collectively. I have left no stone unturned. إِذْ جَاءَتْهُمْ رُسُلُهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ. When the messengers would come, and their messengers came to them from front of them and from behind them. Allah ta'budu illallah, saying, don't worship and obey anything except Allah. قَالُوا لَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّنَا لَأَنزَلَ مَلَائِكَةً. They said, had Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala actually wanted to send some messenger, He could have sent angels. فَإِنَّا بِمَا أُرْسِلْتُمْ بِهِ كَافِرُونَ. So listen, we reject with what you have been sent. You think you are messenger, and you are conveying to us the message of Allah. We reject it. فَأَمَّا عَادٌ فَاسْتَكْبَرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ. So the people of Aad, they showed arrogance in the earth without right. وَقَالُوا مَنْ أَشَدُّ مِنَّا قُوَّةً. And they said, who is more mighty and more powerful than us? أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا. Didn't they see? أن الله الذي خلقهم هو أشد منهم قوة. Then at least Allah who created them is mightier than them in power. Maybe there was no nation on earth more mightier than them. But Allah was there. أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّ اللَّهَ الَّذِي خَلَقَهُمْ هُوَ أَشَدُّ مِنْهُمْ قُوَّةً وَكَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يَجْحَدُونَ. But they remained rejecting and denying our revelations. فَأَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ رِيحًا صَرْصَرًا فِي أَيَّامٍ نَحِسَاتٍ. So we sent upon them a furious wind in days of inauspicious, in order that we make them taste the chastisement of the degradation. فِي أَيَّامٍ نَحِسَاتٍ لِنُذِيقَهُمْ عَذَابَ الْخِزْيِ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا, in the life of this world. وَالْعَذَابُ الْآخِرَةِ أَخْزَى, and the chastisement of the hereafter would be more degrading, more humiliating. وَهُمْ لَا يُنْصَرُونَ, and they will not get any help from any side. وَأَمَّا ثَمُودُ فَهَدَيْنَاهُمْ, as for Thamud also, we guided them, we sent the messenger. فَاسْتَحَبُّ الْعَمَى عَلَى الْهُدَى, but they preferred and loved more blindness than having guidance. فَأَخَذَتْهُمْ صَاعِقَةُ الْعَذَابِ, then they were seized by a thunderbolt of chastisement. عَذَابَ الْهُونِ, the chastisement of humiliation. بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ, with what they were earning. وَنَجَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ, and we saved those, delivered those who had come to believe and they were fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَوْمَ يُحْشَرُ عَدَاءُ اللَّهِ إِلَى النَّارِ. Just imagine the day when the enemies of Allah will be gathered towards the fire. فَهُمْ يُوزَعُونَ, they will be made divided into groups and squadrons. حَتَّى إِذَا مَا جَاؤُوهَا شَهِدَ عَلَيْهِمْ, so that when they come there, شَهِدَ عَلَيْهِمْ سَمْعُهُمْ وَأَبْصَارُهُمْ وَجُلُودُهُمْ, their own sight, their own hearing, their own skins will testify against them. بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ, about what they had been doing. These eyes, these ears, and our skins will testify against us. وَقَالُوا لِجُلُودُهِمْ, and they will say to their skins, لِمَا شَهِدْتُمْ عَلَيْنَا, why have you testified against us? قَالُوا أَنْتَقَنَ اللَّهُ الَّذِي أَنْتَقَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. They will say, today Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made us speak. Just He has made everything speak. وَهُوَ خَلَقَكُمْ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ, and He had created you for the first time. وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ, and you are to be returned to Him. Now why this mention of creation of the first time? When the human beings were created for the first time, there were no hands, no feet, no skins, no body. We were only spirits. Then Allah gave us these things. So they said, we were given to you later. You were created before without us. So you thought that we are not going to testify against you. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us a tongue, and now we are testifying. وَمَا كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَطِرُونَ أَنْ يَشْهَدَ عَلَيْكُمُ السَّمْعُكُمْ وَلَا أَبْصَارُكُمْ وَلَا جُلُودُكُمْ, and you didn't want and never thought of covering yourself, fearing that might be that your own hearing and your own seeing and your own skins would testify against you. You had no idea. وَلَكِنْ ظَنَنْتُمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَعْلَمُ كَثِيرًا بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. On the contrary, you, most of them, you thought that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't know most of the things which they are doing. Now this is important to note, that among a very big segment of the philosophers who follow Aristotle, Mashayin they are called, they think that Allah knows only the major things, major principles, not the details, not the minor details. These minor details are not in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the waswasa, you know. Shaitan whispers into our heart, into our ear, no, no. How is it possible, Allah knowing everything? So do whatever you like. Go on. Allah is not attentive to you. He is not looking at you. He is busy in his own affairs. So these are the things, you know, from Saturn, which make you believe that maybe Allah is not seeing. ذَلَكُمْ ظَنُّكُمْ الَّذِي نَظُنْتُمْ بِرَبِّكُمْ أَرْضَاكُمْ. This was your idea about your Lord. You thought that He knows, He doesn't know all these things. أَرْضَاكُمْ, this has ruined you. You have been destroyed due to this idea. فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. So now you have become from among those who are the losers. فَإِنْ يَسْبِرُوا فَالنَّارُ مَسْوًى لَهُمْ. Now if they endure, if they persevere, then the fire is their abode. وَإِنْ يَسْتَعْتِمُوا فَمَا هُمْ مِنَ الْمُوْتَمِينَ. And if they seek to make amends and permission to go into appeal, it will not be allowed to them. Now no apologies, nothing of the sort. Now this decision is final. وَيَقَيَّزْنَا لَهُمْ قُرَنَا. And we have assigned with them their comrades and their devils, Satans. فَزَيَّنُوا لَهُمْ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ. And they have made whatever is in front of them and whatever is behind them as beautiful to them. Behind them, the creeds and thoughts and customs of the forefathers, that was behind. Well, this is the heritage of our forefathers, our national heritage. We are proud in it. We shall follow it. Whatever is in front of them, this world, and they are engrossed and fully lost in getting the maximum, whatever benefits you can get, whatever comforts or luxuries you can have from this world. So this way, فَزَيَّنُوا لَهُمْ, these Satans, there is one Satan with every human being. This is the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ once said, with every human being there is a Satan. Now, some of the companions took the courage to ask, with you also, O Muhammad ﷺ, is there a Satan with you also? And he said, yes, but I have made it a Muslim. He has surrendered. He cannot do any harm to me. But every person, human being, has a Satan with him. وَقَيَّلْنَا لَهُمْ قُرَنَا فَزَيَّنُوا لَهُمْ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِهِمْ وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ وَحَقَّ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقَوْلِ. And then they deserve the word of punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فِي أُمَمٍ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. Just like those people, those nations who have gone before them, مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ, from above the jinns as well as the humans. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا خَاسِرِينَ. Verily, they are the losers. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَا تَسْمَعُوا لِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ. Very important ayah. And these disbelievers are saying, don't listen to this Qur'an. Now you know the medium of da'wah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Qur'an. Wherever he went, he recited Qur'an, ayat of Qur'an. That was the medium of da'wah. But now people thought that this Qur'an, it's very impressive. It moves the people. People are very much impressed by it. So we should prevent people from listening to Quran. That is why when Muhammad went out for preaching, his uncle Abu Lahab used to go with him, behind him, saying to people, don't listen to him. And he himself used to have new plugs of cotton in his ears. Lest, you know, this, the words of Quran should pass from his ears into his mind, and he might also be impressed. Don't listen. He is a magician. He will, you know, bring you a spell. Don't listen to him. So now here they are saying, قَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَا تَسْمَعُوا لِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ. Don't listen to this Qur'an. وَالْغَوْ فِيهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُغْلِبُونَ. And make noises, boo down, hoot him when he is addressing the people and reciting the Qur'an unto them, so that you can overcome and you can be victorious over Muhammad. فَلَنُزِيقَنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا عَذَابًا شَدِيدًا. So we shall make these people, disbelievers who have rejected, taste the severe punishment. وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَسْوَى الَّذِي كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. And we shall surely and definitely reward them worst of the rewards of what they were doing. ذَلِكَ جَزَاءُ أَعْدَاءِ اللَّهِ النَّارِ. Now, the reward for the enemies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is fire. لَهُمْ فِيهَا دَارُ الْخُلْدِ. In that fire, they will live forever. It will be their abode forever. جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يَجْحَدُونَ. And this will be the recompense and the reward because they were belying and rejecting our revelations. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. And in the hell, those who disbelieve that they are in the hell, they will say, رَبَّنَا O our Lord, أَرِنَا الَّذَيْنِ أَضَلْنَانَا مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ. Please show us those people from the jinns and the human beings who led us astray. They led us to this wrong path. Now please let them come before us. نَجْعَلْهُمَا تَحْتَ أَقْدَامِنَا. So that we can trample over them with our feet. Because they are the reason, our leaders, maybe our ulama, you know, ulama of Yahud, who believed in Muhammad in their hearts. يَعْرِفُونَهُ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاهُمْ. They recognized Muhammad just as they recognized their own sons. But they never came to believe. And they prevented all of their people from believing in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So these ulama, which we called the ulama of evil, ulama su, these ulama, these leaders, these people who in the name of culture are misguiding people. All these things, you know. So they will say, Rabbana arina al-lazayna. Now please, O our Lord, show us those both, min al-jinn wal-ins, from among the jinns and as well as from the human beings, who led us astray. Naj'alhuma tahta aqdamina. We shall trample over them with our feet. لَيَكُونَ مِنَ الْأَسْفَلِينَ. So that they go to the lowest position. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ. Now the seven ayat which are coming, they are most important and very comprehensive and very profound ayat of Quran. And this is included in our course of selected study of Quran. And it is the lesson number 4. This gives a human character. What are the salient features of a mu'min, a person whom Allah loves? What are those characters? And we should read these ayat, but with a mind and with a determination that we should try to acquire this character. Follow the footsteps that are coming. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. Verily those people who say, our Lord is Allah, and then stand fast over it. They remain firm. Now our Lord is Allah. He is the provider. He is to give me help. He has given me life. No harm can come to me except with His permission. If He wants to do something good to me, nobody can prevent Him. He is my friend. Huwa Maulana. He is our friend. Now this relationship, to establish this relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the first step. The faith in Allah. You should have trust in Allah. You should remain happy with whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed for you, which we call razi wa razai rab. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed for me, well, I receive it. And receive it with full pleasure. Maybe it is disturbing for me for the time being. Maybe it is unpleasant, but there must be some good in it because it is coming from my Lord. And He is my friend. He is my well-wisher. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. Then they remained firm on it. تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. Angels come down upon them. One thing is agreed by all, that this coming of the angels is at the time of death. At the time of death, when a truly believing mu'min, when he is going to die, angels come for his welcome. And it is mentioned at so many times that somebody who is dying, he says, no, please make way, they are coming. They see, they start seeing that unseen world, you know, its doors are open. They see the angels are coming. Give them way. So this is, they come. This is agreed upon by all. But in addition, to the believers, this coming down of angels is during the lifetime also. They buck you up. They say, okay, keep firm. You know, because we know from Quran, angels were sent for the help of the Muslims at Badr. Angels were sent for the help of the Muslims in Uhud. So angels do keep on coming. And they give us steadfastness. They support us against evil. You know, within the personality, the inner personality, we have two forces. A force dragging us to bad, evil things. And a force which wants to take us to the good things. The force which wants to drag us down is our nafs. Inna nafsa la ammaratum bisu, the id or libido, according to the Freudian terminology. And the source which wants to take us up is the spirit that is there. The divine spirit in us. Manafaktu fihi min ruhi, which has come from high up and it wants to take us high up. In this same way, outside also, there are forces. There are forces, human beings, who want to take you astray. But there are other human beings also that want to take you on the right path, who are the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the real ummatis of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They have to do it. And also there are invisible forces of the evil and of the good. The invisible forces of jinns, they want to take you to evil and to bad, the invisible forces. And the invisible forces, malaika, they want to take you to the right path. So this is the, you know, the battlefield. Our personality is a battlefield. And there are forces from within, from outside. And this, you know, is going on. Satiza kar raha hai azal se ta'im roos. Chirag-e Mustafavi se sharar-e bulahbi. This struggle between these evil and good has been coming on from the day one of the creation of mankind, and it will continue to the last day. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ اللَّهَ تَخَافُوا. With the message, اللَّهَ تَخَافُوا, don't be fearful, وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا, don't grieve, وَأَبْشَرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ, and rejoice, have the glad tidings of Jannah, of the garden, which you had been promised by your Lord. نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. We angels are your protectors, are your supporters, are your helpers, are your friends in the life of this world also and in the Akhirah also. And in the hereafter. In the hereafter we read, in, you know, paradise, angels will be coming, Tilan Salam and Salama. He is coming and saluting us. And from another door, another angel is coming and saluting us. They will be there, our companions. But they are here also. They are with the righteous people. Support them. You know? So this is a very important thing which some of, you know, scholars of the Muslim world, this spiritual side of our religion is not very clear to them. So much so that they deny these things. There's nothing in it. نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. We are your friends in the life of this world also and in the hereafter. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ. And for you there in the hereafter will be everything that your nafs desires. Your id and libido will also be fulfilled. All the wishes and lusts of your id and libido will be fulfilled to the maximum. Why? And it is logical. In this world, you kept them in restraint. This is haram. You know, your nafs wishes it, wants it. But he said, no, no. أَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَنْ نَفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ. Whosoever kept fearing that he will have to stand before his Lord, and he restrained his nafs. So now the reward should be that in the hereafter, all the demands and lusts and desires of this nafs should be fulfilled to the utmost. Because here you refrained and restrained. لَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ. Whatever your nufus, And here I am again translating as id or libido. Whatever it will demand, that will be fulfilled. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ. In addition, everything which you order, which you say you want, that will also be given to you. Now this second thing will be different for different people. It will be different according to the level of consciousness and thinking of a person. A person might not be able to think of anything very high. So he will ask for something according to his own level, his own mind. There was, you know, a very interesting event. About 20 years back, my friend Dr. Yaqeen, he was coming over to America. So he asked to his sons and daughters, what should I bring for you from America? The youngest daughter said, bring for me a pencil. Now for her mind, pencil was the biggest thing. Maybe she wanted to have the pencil and the elder brother was not giving her the pencil. She wanted to write on the walls and she was forbidden from writing on the wall. So now this was her wish. That's a pencil. Bring a pencil for me from America. This is the level of his mind. So everybody, you know, Aristotle might like to demand something else. Imam Ghazali, what he will demand, a common man's demand and Imam Ghazali's demand, there will be a world of difference between the two. So two parts. Whatever your nafs demands, that is at par. All human beings have that inner libido. Whatever your nafs demands, the fulfillment to the total, to the utmost, will be provided already. But then, whatever you demand, that will be provided. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ نُزُلًا مِّن غَفُورِ الرَّحِيمِ. And all this will also constitute a nuzul. Nuzul. What is this? I have explained that in Arabic culture, when a guest comes, arrives at your door, either he descends from a horse or a camel. Today, he must be descending from a car, but he is called Nazil, Nazil, Nazala. He has come down. And the first thing that you present to him, that is, if it's warm weather, some cold drink, immediately. If it is cold weather, some hot drink. This is called nuzul. Now when he is staying with you, now he is your saif, not nazil. Nazil he was when he just came down off his, you know, ride. But now he is saif. And now you prepare for him ziyafa. And ziyafa, you know, is that you prepare, you take pains according to the level of the person, the guest that you have. You have to prepare accordingly. So this all will be nuzulam min ghafurir rahim. This will be nuzul. For the real, you know, bounties of Jannah, we have read in Surah Sajda. Ma ta'lamu nafsun ma ukhfiya lahum min qurrati ayun. Nobody knows what has been hidden there in Jannah for these people, for the coolness of their eyes. And the Prophet had says, the real bounties of Jannah are ma la aynun ra'at, وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ وَمَا خَطَرَ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ, which no eye has ever seen, no ear has ever listened or heard, and no heart has ever had any idea of it. That is real ziyafa. Quran doesn't mention that. Why? We cannot understand it. That's beyond our perception or comprehension. But only this nuzul, you know, we can understand. So this is described in Quran. Whatever has been described, the bounties of the Jannah, they are nuzul. Now the next step. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Now, when you have become a true bondsman, a true servant of Allah, and you have said that my Lord is Allah, and you have stuck to it. Now the second step is, now you become a preacher, a caller towards Allah. Oh, my fellow beings, come to this path. You should also worship Allah. You should love Allah. You should obey Allah. Why? First of all, the messenger of Allah has said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. None of you can be a true believer unless he likes for his brother also the same thing that he has liked for himself. Now if you have taken to the right path, the urge should be there in you that your brothers, your sisters, your parents, your relatives, people belonging to your nation, they should also come to the right path. So this dawa, first of all we had the surah Zumar, ibadah. Allah ta'abudu illallah. Abudullah mukhlisin allahuddin. Then suratul ghafir or suratul mu'min. Fad'ullah mukhlisin allahuddin. Now the third step is da'wah. Now you call people towards the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. Who can be better in speech than the one who calls towards Allah and does good deeds? And he says, verily I am also from among the Muslims. This is the main theme of this surah. Da'wah. Call to Allah. Call people to Allah. For which the messengers were sent. For which the prophets were sent. And now this duty of calling mankind towards the way of Allah has been given to the ummah collectively. Because no prophets to come now. No messenger of Allah will come. Allah has made this book safe. إِنَّا نَعْرُ نَزَّلْنَا zikra, وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. Take this book in your hand. Go to all the hooks and corners of the world and preach the word of Allah. Convey to them the word of Allah. This is your duty. And this is the second step of the character of a person whom Allah loves. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا. Who is better in speech? A lawyer, he all can make very good speech and argue. A demagogue, he becomes a leader, a dictator due to his power of speaking. But if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the power to speak, then you must use this faculty of yours for propagating the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. But the first condition is that your own deeds should be good. Otherwise, you will be, so to say, bringing bad name to your da'wah. Look to him. What a good speech he makes. But look to him. What is his character? All the effects of your da'wah gone. Wiped off. Look to what he does. So whatever you are calling people towards, you must be practicing it. That is the condition for da'wah. And then, وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Don't think you are something above the people. But you are also from among Muslims. I am also a fellow Muslim of yours. I am exhorting you to understand the duties that you must fulfill for the sake of the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the duties, brother. We have to fulfill them. We have to discharge them. I am also trying to do so. And you please also take upon yourself to accomplish this. وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيَّةُ. And whenever there is a da'wah, there is a conflict. You call towards something and the society is going in the opposite direction. Conflict will be there. It's impossible that there is a da'wah, real da'wah, and there is no conflict. Conflicts will definitely appear. Who are you? Where from have you come? We have been doing this. We have been seeing our forefathers doing this. And now you have come. You say that this is all wrong, false. Who are you? So now the struggle between evil and good. Here you have to be very persevering and forbearing. Bear the good, bad names from people. The jokes from the people. They might say he has gone crazy. He has become a fundamentalist. He has become such and such. You have to hear these things and wear these things. وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ. Evil and good are not equal. So, اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي أَحْسَن. So you should defend and repel the evil in a way which is most beautiful. Your character should be very beautiful characters. مُحْسَنِين. فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةٌ كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيُّ الْحَمِيمِ. The result might be that the person who has enmity towards you today, he might become your friend and very hot friend, Hamim, very sincere friend. وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا. But all these stations cannot be achieved but except by those people who persevere, who take everything with patience, who are patient. وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا ذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٍ. And these stations cannot be achieved except by those who are from their mighty Lord, people of good fortune. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has selected them. Only they will be able to reach this level. May Allah include us among these people. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim wa nafa'ani wa iyaakum bil ayati wa zikr al-hakim.
Allahu Akbar.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us. or call our toll-free number, 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.